We've had a collaboration with SA Water for the last 5 years, and during that time we've been able to see what the major problems are for the state in terms of water management, and obviously SA Water's responsibilities are to try and manage those needs and meet those needs, and we've been able to give that a scientific underpinning by supporting it with real research and growth in knowledge.
The fact that SA Water has decided to go forward with another 5-year agreement, which actually takes it to a 10-year, very strong support agreement of $3.5 million, as I understand it, is something that we're tremendously pleased about.
It's been a terrific experience to work with the University of SA in, first of all, creating this centre together, but as Peter said, signing up for another period of time for what I do expect to be a very long association and a fruitful association.
One of my colleagues, Linda Zhu, is doing some really interesting work in low energy desalination research, and I think the future of desalination will very much lie there. Desalination is a very important technology for securing water supplies for most of the coastal capital cities, but it comes at a cost of very high energy requirements. So there's obviously new research that's required to bring those energy requirements down, and that's very much the focus of Linda Zhu's research. We've done a lot of work in water-sensitive urban design, and we've tried to illustrate that during the facilities tour today. So we're working in permeable pavements with underlying storage, bioretention systems, siphonic roof drainage systems, and so we're enabling people to build water harvesting and reuse into their new developments and into their existing developments.
What I'm standing on here is a driveway. Okay, it's a driveway with stone underneath, but it's on top, it's permeable paving. What's holding all the water that comes through the permeable paving, and it's not just the surface water off the property, which is very difficult to harvest in most instances, it's all four of your downpipes. All four of your downpipes can go anywhere into the base of the system directly. So you've got, instantly, when you put one of these in, you've harvested 100% of your roof water. Okay? But then you're also harvesting a big proportion of your surface runoff of your property, which nobody harvests in Adelaide at the moment. Where does it sit? Does it sit in some expensive rainwater tank underneath the driveway? No, it just sits in the matrix of rock. This whole installation, including the pavers, everything, cost $2,100 delivered to site. That's without labour. $2,100 for a 4,000 litre rainwater tank that you can park your car on. That, in my view, is an incredibly affordable and appropriate technology.
We've got four major research themes. The first one is around Linda's area of desalination, membrane science and nanotechnology. We also have a research theme in securing water supplies, very important for the state of South Australia. We have a theme on treatment for fit-for-purpose reuse, and our fourth research theme is water reuse systems design. So we can give people technologies, very adaptable, very affordable technologies, to allow people to simply reuse more water.
So thank you all for coming, and we look forward to the next 5 years.